Auburn, Alabama, 2008. It was Halloween and we Googled haunted houses. I can't remember what the website was like or if there even was one, but it was like 45 minutes away. I know that it wasn't like a big attraction and we figured it was on someone's land, and would be like a local deal. We drove out there at like 10 p.m. This was before iPhones and GPS, so we had MapQuest directions. We ended up going down a pretty country road for a while with no street lights, then turned down a legit dirt road that went through the woods. Keep in mind it was pitch black. We went down it for like 10 minutes and finally saw an old house with a sign by the driveway that was handwritten and said haunted house. There were no other cars or lights or people anywhere. We pulled in the driveway and sat there for a second like, alright, this is fucked up, we should leave. All of the sudden an old pickup truck turned on about 15 feet in front of us facing us, lights shining right in our faces. It started driving towards us, down their own driveway. We backed out and peeled out. However, we were horrified to find it following us, like almost bumping our rear end. Right on our tail down this pitch black dirt road in the middle of the Alabama woods. We were flipping our shit. It was Texas Chainsaw Massacre / Hills Have Eyes stuff. He stayed out our tail blinding us and almost bumping us all the way back home until we got off our exit and he finally let us go. Till this day I have no idea who was driving, but I always think what would have happened if we got out of the car when we were in that driveway. I was in a large wooded area near my boyfriend's home, hanging out nearly at midnight. We had gone in pretty deep and it required a good amount of climbing. The closest path was maybe 5 to 7 minutes climbing down, so it was highly unlikely someone could be at that spot, that time of the night, besides us. As we were cuddling, my boyfriend thought he saw a shadow move 20 to 25 feet to the left of us, climbing, but it stopped suddenly when my BF looked at it. He told me to be wary, and that exact moment we saw a dark figure climbing a little up but diagonally. Like he tried to go directly above where we were. We didn't move and watched him till he closed the horizontal gap and was directly above us, maybe 15 feet of steep downhill thick forest. Suddenly, he began to come towards us. Without skipping a bit, my boyfriend grabbed my hand and we almost ran downhill till the path. We made it in less than 2 minutes while still holding hands and listening to the man running behind us. We ran as fast as we could down the path and out of the forest where there was a cafe and some basketball and tennis courts next to the wooded hill. And of course, people, as we realized we came really close to be mugged or worse. A little over 18 years ago, I had just gotten out of the military. I drove all the way from Louisiana to my hometown in Montana, without incident. I spent a few days at home and then got back on the road, because my new home destination was Boise, Idaho. It was February, so instead of going straight down the length of the state, I cut across the panhandle of Idaho into Washington. The highway going straight down through the state is really twisty and very dangerous in the winter, so I crossed the state line into Washington. It was a Sunday and it was very, very early in the morning. As cliche as it sounds, there was quite a bit of fog in the air. I had been driving for a while and I really had to use the bathroom. Now, normally, given how I was out in the middle of nowhere, would normally just pull over on the side and take a whiz, but since it was so foggy and hard to see, I thought it safer to just wait until I hit the next small town. So I drove for maybe 5 more miles and I started seeing signs for a town. I can't remember for the life of me the name of the town, but I think it was Linden or Linder, something like that. It was on I-90 going into the Spokane Valley, so I headed towards the sign, which was a right turn off, and I reached the town. It was small, but I thought nothing of it since I was from a small town in Montana. Now here is where things get odd. There was not a single person to be found. There were cars and business, but not a single person around. Everything was just as still as the air. I stopped at a gas station. It was one of those one in all places that did car repair, tires and etc., but no one was at the counter. I thought, well, maybe it's just really early. So I went around to the side to see if the bathroom was locked, and it was. as I made my way back around to the front of the building. I saw a delivery truck. It was a Coke Classic truck. Except it wasn't moving. Its headlights were on, the hazard lights were on, and the passenger and driver's side doors were open, just sitting there in the middle of the street. I was getting a bad vibe, so I got back in my car and went back the way I came to I-90 and thought again about just pissing on the side of the road, but honestly I was too afraid. I continued driving until I hit Spokane. Honestly, I was more than a bit freaked out and had completely forgotten I had to piss. I didn't see anything creepy or hear anything creepy, but the stillness in the air and the complete lack of life, human or animal, was just terrifying and unsettling. I looked on the map to where I was once I got to Spokane, which was a Rand McNally's map, because GPS on phones was just not a thing yet, and I could not find it at all on the map even. I still to this day will never forget that feeling of just freaky displacement I felt there. One time back when I was like 11, me and my friend were walking through the woods because he said he had something he wanted to show me. We walked down the path for a good 20 minutes until he suddenly started walking through some closely planted thin trees. Despite my confusion, I followed him until he suddenly stopped in a clearing and there was a round mud hut in front of us. He told me he was too scared to go inside, so I did instead. The floor was lower down the floor itself and there was a little fire put in the center. It was surrounded by DIY wooden bench things. Although that was odd in itself, the real showstopper were the walls. Every inch or the mud walls were covered in animal skulls held up by a wire. These would range from a small sparrow skull to a deer skull. It was a pretty neat sight, to be frank. Outside of the hut was another small bench which had the phrase, "Where heaven and earth meet," carved into it. Cut to January of this year, and me and my mum tried to find the weird voodoo hut again in the woods. While we did come across the hut, it had sadly been demolished and all but a few of the skulls had been taken. It just kinda looked like someone had jumped on top of it after stealing all of the skulls for the, what I can only imagine, to be some vulture culture collection. It's kinda sad it had to go, but I still remember like it was yesterday.
One night I was out drinking with some buddies and my hobby came up later in the night. The place we were at was starting to die down, so they asked me if there was anywhere cool nearby we could go to. First place that popped into my head was an old abandoned factory that was in the woods, probably a 5 to 10 minute drive away. So we went. Now I didn't quite remember the path to get there. You have to leave the trail at some point. There was a cloud cover, so visibility was super low, and one of them is pretty unathletic thanks to diabetes. So, I had them stay on the trail as I fumbled around in the dark to make sure we were going in the right direction. When I finally got back, they asked how far out I went cause they heard something walk by parallel to the trail. I shook it off and dismissed it as a stray dog or something and lead them into the woods until we hit the fence. I then start leading them along the fence to the hole someone cut forever ago. And when we're getting close, I hear footsteps that weren't ours, maybe 15 feet to the right of us, same side of the fence, and I stop dead in my tracks. In that moment my entire body was screaming at me to run, and the only thing that went through my head in the moment was those were human. I turned back to my friends and judging by the looks on their faces they heard it too. I told my friends we should skip this for tonight and head back. They quickly agreed and started back to the trail as I stayed behind to make sure whoever was there didn't follow them. First dead in a horror movie I know. As I waited for them to get further away, I didn't hear or see anything move. And once I assumed they were back at the trail, I took off running after them and we quickly made it back to the car. Since then I've chalked it up to some homeless dude going to the same place to crash for the night. But it felt like they were following us, and for whatever reason they triggered my fight or flight super hard.
We have a camp that we visit during the hunting months and about every other weekend in between that. To get to our camp, you have to turn off of a major road onto a gravel road, drive about a mile, then turn onto another gravel road for about a half mile. It's set between a few other camps, plus some residents that live out there. It's quiet, for the most part. There are some coyotes and bobcats. Bobcats are there and heard it again. It was a man's voice yelling, "Help me!" repeatedly. Now, our first instinct was to grab our guns. So worse due to their terrible scream. It sounds like a woman crying for help. There has also been a black panther and wild dogs. 2013, we were at the camp for Thanksgiving. We hunted, fished, cooked, drank, all that good camp stuff. On night, we're sitting around a fire, swapping funny stories and just listening to the silence of the woods. As we're talking, we all hear, "Help me." At first, we thought it was a bobcat. We listened some more. Second was to go towards the voice. But you never know what you will encounter in the woods. It was dark and cold. The hunters knew the area very well. We called the police and explained everything to the responding officers. The weird part was that we never once heard it while the officers were with us. Not once. The officers left and we heard the man again, repeating, "Help me." About half an hour later, the officers came back and we didn't hear any call for help. Again, silence. We all decided it was best to go inside our camp for the night. We never did find out anything. I've only been back to the camp once since then. Really freaked me out.